Hartanya tutup semua kedai.
Tak ada buka terus satu hari.
Kajam tutup, Kuala Lumpur tutup.
Bas, tak ada motorcar, tak ada taksi, tak ada apa, tak ada.
Hotel just means a general strike of everybody.
Semua sekali mogok tu nak ketapi tunggu apa mogok.
Hotel ni, matang.
Listening to Radio Malaya. And now, Mr. Malcolm MacDonald, Governor General of Malaya.
Let me say a few words about the most delicate problem in the politics of Malaya. Any realist can see where the main difficulty lies. It lies in the mutual suspicions between different communities, especially between different racial communities, especially between the Malays, who are the indigenous people of this country, and the Chinese, who have played an immense part in its development.
The feeling when the British came back was one of happiness with liberation. But the question was, would the British be the same again as before the war? God save the Queen! You must remember that after the war, the British didn't enforce any of the colonial laws. You didn't have to register a political party, you didn't have to register a trade union, you didn't have to get a press permit. So it was a more or less free country, and the general feeling of liberation was in the air.
Tetapi peperangan telah menyebabkan perubahan seperti yang didapati di lain-lain negeri di Asia.
My name is Lim Kian Chai. I was born in December 1919. In Penang, yes.
Yahya Nasim bin Haji Rusi. Umur saya 88 lebih sikit. Saya berasal dari Ulu Lama.
Perang Jepun tu banyak mengubah fikiran kita. Rupanya kalau tak ada orang putih ni pun boleh. Dulu dia terfikir kalau tak ada orang putih ni mati kita. Bila Jepun memerintah 3 tahun 8 bulan, ya, dia terfikir tak ada orang putih pun boleh juga.
In this atmosphere that you had this political consciousness coming up and the formation of trade unions and all that. So there was a feeling that there was a new world coming up, nobody would stop us.
Malaya, negeri permai yang dicinta dan dipandang sebagai tempat kediaman sendiri oleh berbagai-bagai kaum yang bercakap berbagai-bagai bahasa.
Nama saya Hashim bin Sa'id, tahun 85 tahun. Saya mula-mula sekali masuk politik, saya ada terbaca sebuah buku yang dikarang oleh Cikgu Ibrahim bin Haji Yaakob. Dia menyatakan nasib orang-orang yang kena jajah, negara yang kena jajah, termasuklah negeri kita Melaya pada masa itu, dijajah.
Bila kita baca itu, semangat kita naik, tengkuk kita naik. Sebab dia bentangkan kezaliman penjajah itu di tanah-tanah jajahan. Dia menginsafkan rakyat. Itu yang orang putih sangat takut. Menghisapkan rakyat ini, bahasanya kita punya tanah air, kita punya. Dia datang menjajah, kita mesti suruh dia balik.
And then of course, the great Indonesian uprising against the Dutch inspired the Malays to new heights.
Indonesia punya yang datang tu semangat tu datang kemari sengau. Ha. Pasal sana Sukarno dah beri semangat tu. Sukarno maklumlah kata-kata yang dikeluarnya. Beri saya 10 orang pemuda kata dia boleh menggoncangkan dunia kata. Ha tu dia semangat dia sampai kemari.
Dari situ bermula timbul fikiran kita nak berpolitik. Orang masih sudah tidur lagi. Kita sudah pergi jauh politik.
Tiga hari ini merdeka.
Atuk merdeka.
Semangat merdeka.
Menanamkan semangat merdeka.
VNM ni tujuan dia menyatukan orang Melayu dan memberi kesedaran. Supaya orang Melayu ni punya semangat menuntut kemerdekaan negara dia daripada penjajah British.
Generally, we were an English-educated group and didn't think of ourselves as a party, but rather as a ginger group to wake people up.
They were very powerful. In the Federation, there was the Pan-Malayan Federation of Trade Unions, a coalition of all trade unions. And the most famous leaders were Indian.
Kita kekuatan kita tunjuk setiap Mayday tu. Mayday. Sepenuh-penuh pekan jual baru tu, kita bawa.
Bila ditubuhkan, nak mengembangkan itu masalah.
Ada di kampung-kampung tu macam-macam tengah itu kejadian orang kampung. Ada yang menantangnya, ada. Saya, pak saudara saya sendiri pun menantang saya.
Bila kita cakap mereka ni, masyarakat kita tu setengahnya takut. Setengahnya benci. Dia tak tahu apa benda mereka tu pada dia.
Awak ni gila. Nak merdeka, awak tak tahu awak ni siapa. Orang Melayu ni siapa. Tak tahu orang punca kapal terbang ada, kapal laut ada, kapal apa ada, kapal selam ada. Itu nak kita lawan. Itulah suara yang kita dengar.
Terpaksalah kita terangkan dengan dia baik-baik. Maksud kita tanah air kita ni, kita nak ambil. Pasal apa orang putih ambil tanah air kita? Dia kaya, estet semua dia punya, lombong semua dia punya.
Well, we felt that if the British came back, we couldn't have them running the country because they were very arrogant and couldn't have arrogant people around, and we should govern ourselves.
Keburukan orang British selama dia memerintah tanah Melayu ke bukan, menjajah tanah Melayu ke bukan, dia apa namanya mengaut harta benda di dalam tanah Melayu ini, iaitu tanah Melayu pada masa itu punya kaya ke bukan.
we were the biggest dollar earners in the empire, and our rubber and tin was keeping them afloat. Phony Beatlemania has bitten the
dust. London calling. Dalam Johor saja tahu berapa banyak estet di Sabah je. 600 buah estet.
Jadi dia mesti datang balik. Datang balik dalam bentuk muka barulah.
Melaya tidak wujud sebagai sebuah negara yang sebenar-benarnya bercorak siasat. Melaya mengandungi sekumpulan negeri-negeri Melayu yang setengahnya bersekutu, yang lainnya tidak, masing-masing menumpukan taat setia kepada Raja Melayu dan negeri-negeri Selat yang taat setia kepada mahkota British.
Dia datang, dia bawa Land Union. Land Union ni kira-kira pada satu pihak ada guna, pada satu pihak tak ada guna. Sebab kalau dikira-kira Raja-Raja Melayu akan habis kuasa. Yang kedua, Josulai, kerakyatan akan dipermudah. Mudah dapat kepada orang yang bukan Melayu.
What happened was, in the early days, Dato' On formed the UMNO, in which MNP, Malay Nationalist Party, and the youth, the RP, were members. But they withdrew when they had one vote each against a small little groups from Perak and other states, which had one vote each. So they were outvoted on everything. So as a result, they got out of UMNO.
PKMM dia sendiri ada masa dia tu berbanding juga kompromis juga dengan UMNO. Tapi mesyuarat di Ipoh, UMNO tak taruh keris di dalam merah putih Sang Saka. Kita tak mau, itu kita keluar, langsung keluar. Karena soal itu soal prinsipal, apa sebab keris nak taruh itu, mulia benar ke keris ni?
Jadi keputusannya berpecah. Jadi Parti Kebangsaan Melayu ni memperjuangkan cara kiri dan UMNO menurunkan perjuangannya cara kanan. Itulah timbul dua parti politik, kiri dan kanan.
Well, the right wing will be those who are pro-British. In those days, the left wing were those against the British.
UMNO dia tidak nak merdeka masa itu. Dia hidup Melayu, slogan dia. Kita merdeka.
The MMP and all the other their allies walked out, so that left a rump. And the rub was the royal parties, the small Malay societies of Perak, mainly. And then that was the group that the British chose to negotiate with.
Tiap-tiap raja telah menandatangan satu perjanjian baru dengan kerajaan British, yang demikian menyatukan semua negeri-negeri Melayu, Melaka dan Pulau Pinang menjadi sebuah persekutuan dengan kerajaan persekutuan tertubuh di Kuala Lumpur. Walaupun dalam peta Melaya telah bersatu, tetapi dalam jiwa dan fikiran penduduk-penduduknya belum lagi.
They brought in the federation proposals. And of course, we organized opposition to that because that was another attempt to restore the British colonial governorship under a different name. So we organized a council of joint action. There was the trade unions, the women, the youth coming in to support the movement against the proposals. The MMP, or the PKMM, decided it was better to form their coalition.
PKMM, Api Awas Geram. Dia join dengan kita.
Memang kerjasama dulu untuk menentang Putera Resin ni. Dia pakat semua supaya menentang Putera Resin.
And then these two coalitions will join together to form the Putra AMCJA.
Orang Malaysia apabila tengok ni, apa nama parti kiri ni jadi macam itu ya. Dia berasa besar benar lah.
This gave the registrar the powers of a czar. He could do anything, investigate anything, challenge anybody, question anybody. It was the first concrete proof that the British were beginning to show their hand, that they were going to come back very strong and restore colonial rule. So we fought it with all our might.
Jadi dulu beberapa tahun dulu sebelum ada barisan perikatan, kita dah mulakan ini antara kaum dengan kaum ni.
The unity we talked about never mentioned the racial aspect as is emphasized nowadays. All we wanted was that all the trade unions, all the workers, all the women, all the organizations to join in the broad front to oppose the British return of the governor to rule the country.
Bila kita tubuh itu, ini wartawan-wartawan yang dibagi makan oleh orang putih lah penjajah agaknya. Dia apa? Dia punya propaganda. Dia bilang, Acung Ramasami. Lama tu Acung Ramasami itu dimainkan. Untuk membencikan orang pada kita.
Apabila Federation hampir terselah, Melayu nampaknya mendapat faedah. Perkembang Putera mengapa gelisah? Tengkikan Melayu mendapat tua.
Negeri Melayu, hak Melayu. Ikan senonoh bukannya you. Acong tak boleh bertukar bulu. Ramasami tetap bercorak indu.
The British were not happy with us, with the opposition. They didn't like us to oppose the proposals.
Tapi orang putih dia tak kisah. Bantah-bantah lah, dia jalan juga. Apa kena buat, gitu dia.
Hahaha. we realized it's no use opposing. You got to put in something. And so, to be convincing, we had to put up our proposals. Actually, the People's Constitution is an example of very careful consultation and diplomacy. There was need to put up this constitution because the British had put up their constitutional proposals, and we were out to show that it was a farce, it was a fake, it was really a ploy to put the governor back into power. When the proposal to call the nationality of the new country, Melayu, I had expected a lot of opposition from the Chinese educated, and especially from Mr. Tan Cheng Lock. And to my surprise, they accepted without any discussion. It was immediate, saying, yes, we agree. And that, I think, was our great achievement. Principally, we had a lot of publicity in the press, and of course our own printing. We printed thousands of those things, and we had rallies, big rallies throughout the country explaining constitutional proposals, our constitutional proposals. I mean, look at the meetings we had in Farrer Park in Singapore. You had 20, 30, even the press, British press had 20,000.
Diimpunkan wang dalam satu-satu kampung tu. Kemudian ketua-ketua parti ni pergi sana memberi pandangan.
Sambutan rakyat pun bagus. Kerana rakyat masa itu mulai sedar lah, mulai nampak lah ya. Tanah air ni dia punya ya.
And at that time, the opposition to the proposals was so powerful.
Baru orang pun tahu kekuatan kita ada di dalam. Selama ini dia tak faham.
And if the British did not understand this mood and they wanted to put Malaya back into a pre-war mold, there'll be a lot of trouble. The British completely ignored whatever we put forward. They didn't acknowledge receipt of anything we sent them. That's
the proposal did exist.
Dia menerima hak yang dianukan di saranan oleh UMNO.
Yes, we felt that this will do. We have to do something more drastic.
Pusat Tenaga Rakyat dan Majlis Bergerak Serentak di seluruh Melayu telah mengeluarkan satu maklumat yang dikemparkan petang semalam.
The Putra and the All Malaya Council of Joint Action are calling a Malaya-wide Hartal on October 20th, the day on which the British Parliament will debate the revised constitutional proposals.
Perisytiharan itu memaklumkan bahawa satu gerakan hartal akan dianjurkan di seluruh Melaya pada 20 hari bulan Oktober ini, mulai dari pukul 6 pagi sampai tengah malamnya sebagai membantah perlembagaan Federation.
The Putra and the AMCJ call upon those who regard Malaya as their real home, and upon all those who support the revised constitutional proposals issued by the Putra and the AMCJ to observe a Malaya-wide Hartal on October 20th as a protest against the revised constitutional proposals.
Sa kilid ng daan, nariyan na, nariyan na ang kaaway. Papalapit sa ating hanay. Hanggang mga kaaway, magtaasan ng kamay. Sang tagumpay sa bagong
Jalan raya lapang, kereta-kereta sedikit sahaja yang berjalan.
The Hartal was a complete success in Kuantan. Every single Malay shop in Kuantan was closed on Hartal Day.
吉交三大市镇亚罗四大双溪大年居林作日全响应总拜业.
Ipoh-vil, parku, sinimakal, yavum moodi kedandana.
There was a stoppage of work in all estates in Selangor. The tin mines were also idle.
Di pekan-pekan kecil seperti Merlimau, Jasin, Alor Gajah, Tampin dan Masjid Tanah, didapati semua kedai-kedai tertutup seperti keadaan Bandar Melaka juga.
Practically all fishermen in the fishing villages had refrained from going for their usual catch.
Turimuga tolilalargal velaikku sellave illai.
Di pelabuhan kapal Singapura, pekerjaan dalam 40 buah kapal juga tertutup sebab buruhnya telah berhartal.
Sanlunche, Lorice, Dianche 2084, Desi, quanjie tingxing.
In Victoria Street, Penang Street, there was absence of activity.
Pasar kecil dan besar semua tutup.
Port Swettenham Mill, turimuga tolilalargal anivarum orumugamaga hartale
anishtikana.
Panggung wayang gambar ditutup, tidak mengadakan apa-apa pertunjukan. Taman-taman hiburan juga ditutup.
Asiyargalukku sondamana 99% sthapanangal hartale puranamai
adarikkana.
In some parts of the rural routes, there was an abnormal absence of
sehari semalam penduduk Ipoh langsung tidak dapat membaca suara
Lampuril, Traishakal, Ulanur dikatakan
semua kedai dan
syarikat di kota
semua kedai-kedai perniagaan dalam dan luar kota boleh dikatakan telah tutup. Semua sekali kedai-kedai kepunyaan orang berimpinan hari
semalam penduduk
Ipoh langsung
kedai-kedai bandar Melaka semua yang
kabarkan
dan tidak terbitkan
sementara
sekarang
kabar yang
diterbitkan sementara
sekarang kabar yang diterbitkan
sementara
Darah rakyat masih berjalan, menderita, sakit dan miskin. Padanya datang pembalasan, rakyat yang menjadi hakim. Rakyat yang menjadi hakim. Ayo, ayo, bergerak sekarang. Merah putih panji-panji kita, merah warna darah rakyat, merah warna darah rakyat.
Ciptakan lagu untukmu, nyanyikan syair buatmu tentang perjuangan, tentang pengorbanan. Kau yang bertubuh kecil tetapi berjiwa besar, tegas pendirian dan berhati mulia. Dari utara hingga selatan, lantang suaramu menentang penjajahan, melawan penindasan. Demi untuk negara, demi untuk merdeka, kau sering terpenjara, kebebasanmu dirampas. Tapi jiwamu tetap merdeka. Di atas robohan kota Melaka, kita dirikan jiwa merdeka, kata-kata azimat darimu pernah kami lupa. Walaupun kini jasadmu telah tiada, namun semangatmu membakar jiwa rakyat Malaysia yang tak pernah melupakan pengorbananmu. Rakyat Malaysia.